I started noticing plastic washing up on my local beach. Dresses, shoes, tights, underwear, swimming costume, fancy dress, school uniform. I began to realise that overconsumption is just such a huge and massive problem, and I think we've just lost track of what's valuable. And I've been photographing marine plastic debris for the past 15 years. I realised that if I made a visually beautiful aesthetic, this drew the people in to see what they were looking at. And once I'd got their attention, I then had the platform to give them information. It's like a stab in the back, so when they read the captions and the information, you know, I've been able to get over the message of what's going on. The first project was called Indefinite, and it started off with a plastic bag, and I researched into how many years it took them to degrade in the ocean. So the project started from like 1 year and then ended up with Indefinite, which was a piece of polystyrene. Since then, we know that all plastic exists in the ocean, unless it's been burnt, you know, since it's been produced. Research from scientists have showed that now we have microplastics in our brains, in our blood, and in our major organs. So science has moved on incredibly since 15 years, since I first started photographing it. Once I'd photographed single objects, I realised there was mass accumulations around the world. So I wrote to scientists and educators and asked them to send me plastic from their local beaches that had significance. And I created these mass accumulations of plastic to let people know what was happening in the ocean. It's very important to me that people see the brands and see the names and the makes that are actually out there littering the shores, because you can say, you know, this is what we've discovered here, and don't you think you ought to be doing something about this? You know, get rid of the plastic yourself. I thought it would be a really good idea if I could collaborate with scientists. If I could back up the things that they are finding out through my work, then it gives it more credibility, because scientists aren't subjective, you know, they have to be true to the facts, but then an artist can be slightly more creative and it can present the same facts in a different way that for them would help raise awareness of their research. This new project I've done, which is based on synthetic clothing, is different to my earlier work, but as I was collecting like solid plastic objects, I began to realise that there was a lot of material and clothing kind of bound up in it. And I found a strip of cloth that looked exactly like a piece of seaweed. Initially, I was quite, enticed by it. It was kind of an attractive, beautiful piece of cloth, but I hadn't really been noticing that. You know, I'd been picking up brightly coloured objects and not really looking at what's actually entangled in the seaweed. So I realised that actually there's a problem with the fast fashion industry, with synthetic clothing, being discarded and also found in the sea at the same time. So this is just one of many drawers full of the fibres and pieces of clothing and garments that I've collected over the years. And, you know, they're all quite degraded, they've all got holes and, you know, they're all a bit ragged and threadbare through the time spent in the sea. A T-shirt can have been put together and made in six different countries and then shipped across, you know, right halfway across the world to be then sold for £3 or £4. You know, it's just kind of lost, and you just see that T-shirt, however, is on the hanger. But there's so many implications, you know, through production and manufacture that need to be resolved. I then came across the work of Anna Atkins, who's a Victorian botanist from the 1800s. And what she did was collect seaweed around the coast of Britain, and she pressed them and made these beautiful cyanotype prints. A lot of the image seemed to look to me like pieces of clothing. The fonds of seaweed and things like that looked like the fibres of, say, a pair of trousers or pieces I'd found. And that's when I had the idea to, instead of using seaweed as she did, use the recovered pieces of clothing that I'd found and raise awareness of this current issue. The way I apply the solution to the paper is using the clothing itself, because I had the idea that some of the microfibres within the clothing would then adhere to the print, and I just thought there was something really kind of unusual about the print actually having microfibres in itself. I decided initially to create prints that looked exactly like Anna Atkins seaweed, because I wanted to trick the viewer and make people think that perhaps a new print or a new book had been found of her work. And then when they realised they weren't, they were looking at this really serious current climate issue, they would be kind of shocked in the realisation that it isn't what they're looking at, it's actually a huge problem. This is the original book that I created using the prints on Whatman paper, the same paper that Anna Atkins used. The marbling was specially created in the style of the 1800s, and everything has been replicated exactly the same as her book, even down to the markings on the pages. All the handwriting has been replicated by myself in the same style, with the text changing appropriately. The labels originally and the algae that Atkins used, I've changed the second part of the name to make, in Latin, the name of the garment that I recovered. Each of the prints is unique because the way that you coat the paper, the exposure to the sun, all has a different impact every time you make a print, so every print is different. And as I went on, I realised that I wanted to put my own mark on the book, and I changed some of the compositions to look like how I found the material on the shoreline. The first quote on the first page describes a fact about the fast fashion industry. It's responsible for more greenhouse gases than all container shipping and all flights combined. Now that quote just kind of blew me away. I couldn't believe that because, you know, people try and save on flying, and they're mindful of their carbon footprint, but actually, if they were to buy two or three items of clothing, they're probably doing more damage than they are going on a plane. That was the quote that had to go in there in the beginning, and that everything follows from there, just to be thoughtful of what people buy and discard. We don't need to make any more. We don't need to keep producing clothing. We can share and reuse. And from doing this project, I've had a lot of people write to me and say that they're not going to buy any clothes for a year, which is the best outcome for me, because if I'm saying what I'm doing and people are reading it and thinking about it, then I couldn't think of a better solution than having looked at my artwork and, acted on it.